One man's dream becomes a nation's reality tomorrow when Barack Obama becomes America's first African-American president. Only in America. That's how many describe the realization of Martin Luther King's dream. But what progress has that dream made here? Well, tonight we look at the city of Greensboro, a city with a rich history in the civil rights movement, to answer that question. And Bill O'Neill joins us now live with the story. Bill?
Cam, there's no simple answer. It is clear that things have changed, and everyone I spoke with today says that things have changed for the better, but that more progress is needed.
Let's get together and be all right.
Before America elected a black president, Greensboro elected a black mayor, a black congressman, black leaders to the city council and state legislature. The city has hired several black police chiefs, a black school superintendent, and the list goes on and on.
It's a lot different. I have my kids, something they can look forward to, something they can cherish, and, you know, maybe one day they might be sitting up there in that seat, you know? You never know.
At age 34, Damian Brown missed the city's toughest days of racial unrest. But James Earl remembers them well. Over the course of your lifetime, have you seen Greensboro make strides along racial relations
fronts? Oh, yeah, sure.
Certainly have. I remember when I couldn't even go into place to eat, you know?
Nearly 50 years after four A&T students staged a sit-in protest at the Woolworth's lunch counter, the city now plans to open a civil rights museum at the same site. It's one sign of how far Greensboro has come, but everyone we talked with today says the city still has a ways to go. Cassandra Mayo says she'd like to see more opportunities in education and business for minorities.
I would like to see that more because I work in corporate America and I don't see that. I'm in the accounting field and it's still not enough of our minority people in those areas.
Has this community made any strides to your,
sure,
to your knowledge?
Somewhat, yeah.
Somewhat?
Still a lot room to go yet. Yeah.
Such as?
Well, housing. Business is coming in.
J.L. Payne, a retired school principal, says he'd like to see more integration. Schools, government, and the workplace are more integrated today, but social groups, like the Masons, for example, remain segregated. The city's police department remains a hotbed for racial unrest as well. 19 African-American officers are suing the department for discrimination. The department's former police chief, who is white, is also suing for discrimination.
I've seen a lot of progress. Actually, I'm 53 years old today, so I was here when they had the riots at A&T, doing the sit-ins and everything, you know, and I've seen a lot of progress here. I'm proud of Greensboro.
For some, the dream of equality is becoming reality. For parents like Damian Brown, Barack Obama offers hope for his children's future.
Just give them the opportunity. That's the whole thing, give my kids the opportunity.
Greensboro certainly has its share of racial problems, but Cam, it is also a community that talks about those problems. They may not always agree, but there is awful lot of discussion in this town about what is going on and what the future may hold in store, Cam.
All right. Thank you. Bill O'Neill, live for us tonight in Greensboro.